Welcome back. Abhishek Goenka, founder and CEO, IFA Global, now joins us on the show live to talk about the currency markets. Abhishek, hi. It's been some day where we've seen a sell-off in equities, sell-off in commodities, and the currency, of course, has been a part of it.
Yeah, I mean, I think it feels like the rupee doesn't want to weaken, but somehow because of the stock markets and the global markets is tightly getting weak. And I think a surprising fact is the last levels of 68.25, which it has been testing for the four times and had come back to 67.5, got broken today. And in the NDF markets right now, we can see levels of around 68.40, even though it's close at 30 in the domestic markets. So it seems that if the markets globally don't improve, we could see further weakness happening in the rupee, maybe 20-30 paisa higher. But we have to be very, very careful, because since, you know, it could be an eye of the storm that we could see some kind of weakening happening in the markets and suddenly we see a reversal. So I think it's very, very cautiously one has to take the positions in the rupee, and importers need to buy with a stop loss, clearly. I mean, we just cannot keep our positions open. And I think exporters keeping their stop losses at 68 levels. I think that's the advice.
Abhishek, what's your sense on the currency as we go ahead? I mean, of course, you voiced that caution there, but the rupee is the worst emerging market performer in currency space. Is that how we are starting 2016?
So I think if you look, as you rightly said, the emerging market currencies like Malaysian Ringgit, Thai Baht, you were just checking, all are up. I mean, it's only the Chinese currencies, because of the Asian markets and because of Indian markets, rupee is weak. I don't see a one-sided move in the rupee. I would say I will still stick with a view of 66.5 to 70 for the next 7 months. I think right now the pressure is building on the rupee, but surprisingly we will see about an appreciation also. So I don't think we should just consider that it's going to be a one-way straight up towards 70. I think both side moves, so both buyers and sellers will get opportunities in the market.
One final very quick question then, because we've seen the Japanese yen gain up by 7%. The euro is up nearly 5% as well. So do you think these are the currencies to put money in and they will continue to be consumer friendly?
I think Japanese yen, I think it's entering slowly and steadily into a buy zone, because the last 9 days, it has appreciated all the way from 121 to 111. And such a sudden bout of appreciation, I'm sure we're going to see a big correction happening in the Japanese yen. It's because of the carry trade unwinding, because of which the euro and the Japanese yen has been going up. I think we could see a strong correction. I would not buy the Japanese yen at these levels. In fact, I would look at the bottom and I will start taking positions on buying the US dollar against the Japanese yen.
Fair point. Noted all of that, Abhishek. Thank you so much for joining us and giving us a quick wrap on how you should be trading your currencies and, of course, what to expect in markets tomorrow. With that, completely out of time on Commodities First. Thank you for watching.